wheels and four wheels, sneaking off with her for that first time. You can thank a farmer.
Hey guys, so we are field finishing on corn stalk ground, going about 6.3 mile an hour, and sometimes we're going in 10th gear, sometimes we'll shift down to 9th on the hills. This is a Great Plains 26 foot discovator, or as we like to call them, a field finisher or a field cultivator. This tractor's an 82-85R John Deere. It's like a 2012, I think. But it has a chip in it, and it's pushing about 360 horse. So, it pulls it pretty nice. Except for on the hills, it wants to pull down a little bit. Probably gonna have to shift down on this hill. I like to shift down if it gets below 2,000 RPM. Starts pulling hard like this. This tractor's just got the power shift in it. It don't have the IVT. IVT would be nice, but new learning curve and everything like that. Back up now that we're over the hill. And we usually like to put our diff lock on right there. Such as right there. When I turn around, I've just been leaving it in the ground just enough to cover up my tracks, so then you don't gotta go back and do end rows. We don't always do it like that, but I don't know, I just decided to on this field. I've done it before. star on here. And then you gotta hit the brakes to get that diff lock to go off, otherwise it's not easy to turn. Diff lock back online, diff lock on. We'll probably have to shift down up here. I was started going on this field at about 9 and it's 10:08, so yep. We'll shift down. This is the 8326, the field finisher, which means it's 26 foot, as I said before. Going about 6, now we're going about 7 down the hill. Definitely gonna have to shift down up this hill. Can already tell that. Watch our RPMs and our heat gauges and everything like that. Make sure nothing gets hot. Pulling down a little bit on this little hill. Should be fine though. The reason I'm just not really lifting up and completely turning around is because then when I go back and do end rows, I won't have to do as many passes. Been recording here. This is just on my SJ Cam app. Pretty dusty out. We're burning 0.8 gallons an acre, and we're doing about 17 acres an hour. Too bad. Here's our mapping. And then, there's your 6%. What we're slipping right now. But you can set this whole screen up to where you can put different stuff on it, whatever you want. But I'm gonna talk a little bit more about my camera here that I got. But yeah, this is the SJ Cam 5000X Elite. That's what I'm using to record right now. So far, I really like it. It cost about $150, which wasn't too bad compared to a GoPro. Down here. Yeah. I think it's got about the quality of a GoPro. Really, I'm pretty happy with it overall. I want to mount it on, like, the frame of the field collimator or something and get some footage that way, but as of right now, I don't have a good way to do that. I don't have a magnet mount right now or anything. I do plan on getting one, and if any of you guys have suggestions on how to mount it on stuff like that, that'd be greatly appreciated, because I've never done it before, and I really don't know, and I don't want the thing to fall off and get buried, because I would never find it. Right now, we're just gonna do head cam videos. Probably next year we'll get better. I do have a couple sticky mounts, but I don't know how well those work. Why are we in 8? Oh, I better forget to shift up. That's going hard. I'll probably make these videos about 15 minutes long, and we're coming right up on 15 minutes here, so, well, I suppose I'll on this one. And thanks for watching. Comment, like, subscribe. Talk to you guys later.